Hi again, in this video I will show you how to compute the displacement on a bar or truss in 1D problems by solving the equilibrium equation, which is a Poisson equation using Python, and compare it to the analytical solution of Poisson equation. In the last video that I shared in this channel, I explained how to solve equilibrium equation and obtain the strong form in form of Poisson equation, then deriving the weak form and discretizing this equation using finite element in case of a one-dimensional problem. In this video we solved the linear system of equation that we obtained after discretization of a weak form of equilibrium equation. So I used Python for solving this problem. So first step is to define the number of element n equal to 5. Then I must have my coordinate x for each node. So I have n number of x coordinate. I use a random coordinate. So I import random Python. So I have my 5 random number between 0 and 1, which is my limit of domain in x axis. Then I must sort these numbers from minimum to maximum. I use numpy impose. So I try again. My x now would be from 0.28 to 0.7. Now I should compute the size of each element dx. I image number of element would be one less than number of nodes. X I minus X I minus 1. So as in Python I start from 0, so I would to have I minus 1, so I would be I plus 1. Now we start from 0, I would be 1 and I minus 1 0, so now I would have my dx element that is positive size of element with random. I have element with different size. So now I will build up my stiffness matrix that we computed in last video. So it would be number of element minus the two known displacement at the boundary. N minus Let's do it, say n minus 2, n minus 2 matrix, and as we computed in last video, it is a tri-diagonal matrix. At the diagonal term would be I 1 over delta x I minus 1 plus 1 over delta x I, and the upper and lower diagonal would be minus 1 over delta x I. So I compute diagonal term. N minus 2, diagonal term has n minus 2 entries, I is my diagonal term, and 1 over delta x plus 1 over delta x I plus 1. This is my diagonal term. For upper diagonal, so I plus 1 for upper diagonal, and is minus I plus 1. This is that for I plus 1, and for lower diagonal term, now for rho would be 1 plus I term, and I should pay attention that the number goes 1 less than the diagonal term. So now if you see your matrix, so is it tri-diagonal, and the upper and lower are equal, now we compute our F force matrix. Or if, as we computed in previous video, is delta x I minus 1 plus delta x I divided to 2. I plus delta x I plus 1 divided to 2. This is also is for F. Okay, if I should be in pi zeros, should be array of n minus 2, same size of stiffness matrix. Now I have my F. So now I have F and K. I can compute displacement by solving this linear system of equation in P linear. Mm-hmm. So now I can solve my U, but this U doesn't contain the boundary terms to have a total U total including the boundary terms, so I need to add boundary term at 0 and 1, which was U0 at these boundaries. Okay, it's important. And also at 0. Now I have displacement total including the boundary non-boundary displacement 0, so I can plot my solution. So it's because my number of elements, I should increase them. So this is the finite element solution for this bar, and we can also compute the analytical solution for this Poisson equation, considering E Young modulus and A cross section equal to 1, then the Poisson equation would be D2U dx to the power of 2 plus 1 equals 0. Then by 2 times integration of this equation and obtaining the constant A and B using boundary terms, we can have the analytical solution for this equation equal to minus x to the power of 2 divided to 2 plus x divided to 2. So if I plot the analytical solution here, analytical solution would be equal to minus x I to the power of 2 divided to 2 plus x I divided to 2. So I don't want that my x for analytical solution be random, so I would use np space 0 and 1. x . So this is the orange one is the analytical solution, and the blue is the finite element. So if I increase my, so because it's random, is already not that bad as the size of element are random, and the solution is piecewise linear for the finite element. And if I remove the randomness here, and I create fixed 5 number of the nodes from 0 to 1, now we can see the piecewise solution for the finite element blue and the analytical with 5 nodes and the analytical solution for this problem. I hope this video was helpful. I will try to continue preparing more videos and examples. Please subscribe to the channel and let me know if you have any comments or suggestions. Thank you for watching.